Hi everybody, today is February 1st, 2013. Burma to send officers to U.S. Thai military drill. Burma's military will send two officers to observe to Cobra Gold, a major U.S. and Thai-led multinational military exercise held in Thailand on February 11th through the 12th, the Bangkok Post reports. About 12,700 soldiers from Thailand, the U.S., Singapore, Japan, South Korea, and Indonesia will be involved in the annual exercise, and 101 countries are sending observers. Burma will join the latter group. Thai Lieutenant General Tarshwin Sirwan, Director of Joint Operations of the Supreme Command, told the newspaper. The possible participation of Burma's military was first reported in October and has been controversial. The powerful military ran Burma under a repressive dictatorship until 2011, while its units still remain linked to human rights abuse. So that's just next week. It sounds more like preparing for World War III. Going to be 12,700 soldiers. How many from the U.S., Singapore, Japan, South Korea, and Indonesia are going to be involved? USS Bonham Richard departs for deployment Cobra Gold. Forward deployment amphibious assault ship USS Bonham Richard, flagship of the Bonham Richard Amphibious Ready Group, departed January 24th for a deployment in the 7th Fleet areas of operation. Bonham Richard will embark Marines of the 31st Marine Expeditionary Unit to take part in the amphibious integration training and certification exercise. Participants in the annual multinational combined joint training exercise Cobra Gold and conduct various other exercises aimed at increasing mission readiness. Goes on to say that AIT and CERTEX are training exercises focusing on the ARGs and 31st MEU amphibious assault capabilities, humanitarian assistance capabilities, disaster relief operations, and non-combat evacuation missions. Cobra Gold is an annual U.S. and Kingdom of the Thailand joint-sponsored joint multinational exercise intended to demonstrate the ability to rapid deploy a joint task force to conduct combined operations at sea and ashore. This deployment also marks the first time many junior enlisted sailors will get underway for a full deployment. Notice it says a full deployment aboard Bonham Richard. So they're evidently already there. Myanmar to observe Cobra Gold. Myanmar would send two officers to observe the Cobra Gold military exercise next month. And this was published yesterday. A senior Thai Armed Forces official said on Thursday. Now this article says 12,700 soldiers from Thailand, United States, Singapore, Japan, South Korea, and Indonesia will be involved in Cobra Gold. So I wonder if that's the total amount of soldiers they're going to be deployed. Here's another article. Shilho visits Republic of Korea for Aegis interoperability event. Republic of Korea NNS ballistic missile defense capable Tikrong Droga class guided missile cruiser USS Shilho arrived in Busan, January 30th for a port visit, conduct military-to-military exchanges. Shiloh Commanding Officer Captain James T. Jones was welcomed by Republic of Korea Navy Captain Kui Sung Muk, Commanding Officer of the ROKS Choi Young, DDH-981 upon Shiloh's arrival in Busan. The lessons learned in training will help us improve our interoperational ability and our ability to work together in the future, said Jones. With a crew of approximately 300 sailors, Shiloh is conducting a port visit in Busan to support Aegis interoperability training for joint and combined ROK and U.S. forces. Military-to-military exchanges such as this Aegis interoperability event are intended to strengthen cooperation and improve overall mission effectiveness through focused dialogue and hands-on training. Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense, BMD, provides a mobile missile defense capability within international waters to protect both the U.S. and our allies. Interoperability training opportunities such as this one enhance the combined effectiveness of the ROK-US alliance. Shiloh is one of the two U.S. Navy cruisers forward deployed to Yokosuka, Japan. The ship is now on a routine Western Pacific patrol. Now this article states that from Camp Foster, Okinawa, Japan, service members from every branch of the U.S. military will join military members throughout the Asian Pacific region to participate in Exercise Cobra Gold 2013. CG-13 is the 32nd iteration in a series of reoccurring multinational or multi-service exercise hosted annually by the Kingdom of Thailand and developed by the Royal Thai and the U.S. militaries. Now, Thailand is one of the countries that has also claimed ownership of these disputed islands between China and Japan, along with Vietnam, the Philippines, etc. Here it says that participants from 7 full participating nations and many other observing nations are going to be there. They said there's going to be 13,000 participants from full participating nations. The seven are the Kingdom of Thailand, the United States, Singapore, Japan, Republic of Korea, Indonesia, and Malaysia. Remember, I told you there's going to be 101 countries going there to watch this. So, if war does break out, I guess you can consider it the start of a world war, wouldn't you? It actually gives some of the dates for different operations. The 11th is the opening ceremony, the 14th amphibious assault demonstration, the 15th small boat raid, the 16th helicopter raid, 17th multilateral non-combatant evacuation operation, transportation of Japanese nationals overseas, and it names the area. The 18th jungle warfare training at a recon camp. The 19th, chemical, biological, radiation, and nuclear training. Thursday the 21st, three events will take place very close together and in order below. Humanitarian and civic assistance dedication ceremony, combined arms, live fire exercise, and then the closing ceremony. This is a much bigger event, and this should be all over the news. Like I said, I figured this weekend maybe, I think North Korea might detonate their nuclear test. I don't know. We'll just see. Interesting. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.